Good evening, it's 8 o'clock. The top headlines tonight. As the rate of vaccination slows down, the government now warns healthcare workers and frontline workers of all states that they should vaccinate by their deadline or join a general queue. The center says this to states and health workers, as by 6th March, they say healthcare and frontline workers must end their vaccinations, and by 6th March, over 50s are likely to begin getting shots. Anyone left over can then join the general queue. Meanwhile, the good news, zero deaths in Delhi for the first time in 10 months. In Uttarakhand, rescue operations continue, but time is running out. Meanwhile, hoping against hope, a village waits. In Parliament, the Prime Minister's tearful farewell to the leader of opposition, the Congress's Ghulam Nabi Azad. Meanwhile, Azad's tears as well in his last speech and his words, proud to be a Hindustani Muslim. Farooq Abdullah in the Lok Sabha says, you say Lord Ram is yours, he belongs to us too. And Akhilesh Yadav asks, what about Chanda JVs, those who are collecting donations? The CBI gives a clean chit to their likely next boss. Rakesh Asthana is cleared of bribery charges. He is in running now to be the next CBI chief. Petrol and diesel prices are at a record high again. How is it impacting your budget? Our special report. The youngest Kapoor brother, Rajiv, dies at 58. He dies of a heart attack. Our lead story tonight, well, at the Health Ministry press conference, deadlines now for vaccinations, as the rate of vaccinations for healthcare and frontline workers who are currently being vaccinated is slowing down. Sukriti has the latest. Sukriti, what's the new vaccination calendar the centre has said?
Well, yes, now there have been dates that have been set for both healthcare and frontline workers whose vaccinations are supposed to be carried out. For healthcare workers, by the 20th of February, all states have to schedule at least the first dose of vaccination for them. By 24th of February, their mop-up rounds are supposed to end. Similarly, for frontline workers, the first dose of vaccination is supposed to be done by 1st of March, and their mop-up rounds are supposed to finish by 6th of March. Anybody who does not turn up on the scheduled dates or does not turn up in the mop-up rounds, then these healthcare and frontline workers will then be shifted to the next phase of vaccination, when those above 50 or below the age of 50 and have comorbidities, those will start getting vaccinated. And that vaccination for the general public is expected to begin somewhere around 2nd week of March or after that. And while the exact modalities for the general public are yet to be announced, there are certain systems that have been set in place. The government is already taking the data of all those above the age of 50 through the electoral rolls, so that data is already being fed into the COVID database. Once the system and the database has all of these names and the details, then they will start opening up COVID as a mobile app as well as a website. Right. Somewhere in the second or third week of March, they will open this up to the public, and then the modalities will be announced on how they can log into the system and put in their details.
But also, of course, there's great news today that the capital of India, Delhi, has had zero deaths in the last 24 hours. And also, this is a pattern now across many states and union territories as well.
Well, yes, Delhi has had only has had zero deaths in the last 24 hours, and this is the first time in 10 months. So the last time we had zero deaths was somewhere in April, and since then, this is the first time when we've registered zero deaths. Delhi had been seeing less than 10 deaths in the last 7 days or so, but in the last 24 hours, it's at zero. Similarly, for nationwide COVID figures as well, it's good news, as at least 15 states and union territories have not reported any new deaths in the last 24 hours. There has been a 55% decline in average daily deaths in last 5 weeks.
So that's fantastic news there, Sukriti. Thanks so much for that update. We're moving to the other big headline in Uttarakhand. Time is now running out for those who are trapped in the Tapovan tunnel. Also, a village is waiting for news of their loved ones. There are at least 200 people still missing after the Uttarakhand disaster on Sunday.
Roshan Lal is reconciling himself to the worst as he awaits news of his missing son, Rahul, who was expecting a child this month. Rahul worked at the Heidel power plant and has been missing since Sunday's flash flood at Tapovan.
कार्य कर रहे हैं तो हम भी क्या कर सकते हैं, अब टनल के अंदर तो हम नहीं जा सकते, अब उम्मीद भी बैठे हैं कल परसों तक जब तक भी रहेंगे।
कबीर प्रधान एंड अब्दुल वाजिद आर वेटिंग होपिंग देयर ब्रदर्स आर स्टिल अलाइव।
जिस दिन ये हादसा हुआ उसी दिन से उनका कॉन्टैक्ट खत्म हो गया, ना कोई फोन पर बात हुई ना, उससे दो घंटे पहले घर उन्होंने बात की ठीक ठाक थे, लेकिन जब 10:40 पे हादसा उसके बाद आज तक कोई कॉन्टैक्ट नहीं हुआ उनसे।
Many who survived described the horror, clinging to bars high up in the tunnel.
मैंने सोचा कि डंपर पलट गया हमारा जो करिशर पे चलता था, इतनी हाइट उसकी होगी कुछ कह नहीं सकता हूँ उसके बारे में सर, उसका तो अनुमानित है वो, और इतनी जल्दी था कि मतलब 30-35 या 40 सेकंड ही होगा सर जो मैं नीचे से दौड़ के और ये जगह जो डंपिंग एरिया है वो डंपिंग एरिया पे पहुंचना।
Hundreds of families and friends are waiting at the NTPC site where the rescue work is going on to save about 37 trapped inside the tunnel of the power plant.
We have been able to at least go ahead around 100 meters. The challenging task is that as we are clearing the debris and slush, more of it is gushing out. Okay. So that is the main challenge because that prevents us from walking on foot.
Aerial surveys are also being conducted in the entire area to look for any survivors.
All eyes on the rescue operations that are going on right now against all odds. The rescue teams are leaving no stones unturned to continue with the rescue work to keep the hope alive of those who are waiting to see their loved ones trapped inside. With Dinesh Mansera and camera person Ashwini Mehra, I'm Akshay Dongre for NDTV.
The Home Minister also made a short statement today on the disaster, and in both Houses of Parliament, a minute of silence to remember those who lost their lives in the Uttarakhand disaster. Well, making headlines today in Parliament was Prime Minister Modi's tearful farewell to the leader of opposition, the Congress's Ghulam Nabi Azad, whose Rajya Sabha term has finished. Ghulam Nabi Azad gave an equally emotional response with tears and also said that when he sees what the situation is in Pakistan, he is proud to be an Indian Muslim.
Gujarat ke yatri, kyunki Jammu Kashmir mein jaane wale tourist mein Gujarat bahut bada number rehta hai. और टेररिस्टों ने पर हमला कर दिया, करीब 8 लोग शायद मारे गए। प्रणब मुखर्जी साहब डिफेंस मिनिस्टर थे, मैंने उनको फोन किया, मैंने कहा साहब अगर फोर्स का हवाई जहाज मिल जाए इन डेड बॉडी को लाने के लिए, रात देर हो गई थी। प्रणब मुखर्जी साहब ने कहा आप चिंता मत कीजिए, मैं करता हूँ व्यवस्था। लेकिन रात में फिर गुलाम नबी जी का फोन आया, वे एयरपोर्ट थे, उस रात को एयरपोर्ट से उन्होंने मुझे फोन किया और जैसे अपने परिवार के सदस्य की चिंता करें, वैसी चिंता सत्ता जीवन में आती रहती है, लेकिन उसे कैसे पचाना
मैं एयरपोर्ट पे पहुंचा तो इन बच्चों ने, जिसका किसी का पिता मर गया था, किसी की मां मर गई थी, वो रोते रोते मेरे टांगों से जब लिपट गए तो मैं जोर से, मेरी आवाजें निकल गई, ये खुदा ये क्या तुमने किया, मैं कैसे जवाब दूं इन बच्चों को, मैं कैसे जवाब दूं उन बहनों को जो यहां तफरी के लिए आए थे, सैर के लिए आए थे, और आज मैं लाशें लेकर इनके हवाले कर रहा हूं उनके माता पिता के। तो ये भावुक होने की जरूरी बात, आज हम ये अल्लाह से, भगवान से यही दुआ करते हैं कि इस देश से मिलिटेंसी खत्म हो जाए, इस देश से आतंकवाद खत्म हो जाए। मैं उन खुशकिस्मत लोगों में हूं जो पाकिस्तान कभी नहीं गया, लेकिन जब मैं पढ़ता कि वहां किस तरह के हालात हैं पाकिस्तान के अंदर, तो मुझे गौरव महसूस होता है, मुझे फख्र महसूस होता है कि हम हिंदुस्तानी मुसलमान।
Also in the Lok Sabha today, strong speeches by Dr. Farooq Abdullah and ex-UP Chief Minister Akhilesh Yadav.
क्या जिस डिस्ट्रिक्ट से महामहिम राष्ट्रपति जी आते हैं, क्या उस डिस्ट्रिक्ट में MSP किसानों का मिला है धान का कि नहीं मिला है? देश के डिफेंस मिनिस्टर भी वहीं से आते हैं, बताओ क्या मिला है MSP धान का? उस आंदोलन के बारे में क्या कहा जा रहा है कि आंदोलन जीवी है? मैं उनको क्या कहूं, मैं उन लोगों को क्या कहूं जो लगातार चंदा लेने निकल जाते हैं, क्या वो चंदा जीवी संगठन के लोग नहीं है?
मैं मुसलमान हूं तो क्या हिंदुस्तानी मुसलमान नहीं हूं? और आप अगर हिंदू हैं तो क्या है, क्या वो पैदा करने वाला नहीं है? भगवान जो है और अल्लाह जो है वो सब एक है। किसानों से बात करके कोई हल निकाल ये ठीक नहीं है। हमारा पार्टी का 70 साल का एक है कि हमने 370 खत्म करना है और 35 खत्म करना है, हमने देश को एक करना है। हम कब देश में नहीं थे? आपने कभी देश के बारे में कहीं बात नहीं की। मैं वो हूं जिसने यूनाइटेड नेशन में हिंदुस्तान के बारे में बात की। आज हमें पाकिस्तानी कहते हैं, खालिस्तानी कहते हैं, चीनी कहते हैं। मुझे अफसोस है, राम सिर्फ आपका है, राम तो विष्णु का राम है, याद रखिए। और अगर वो विष्णु का राम है तो हम सबका राम है।
पार्लियामेंट हाईलाइट्स टुडे। ऑल्सो इन अदर न्यूज एंड NDTV एक्सक्लूसिव, अरविंद हैज मोर ऑन हाउ वेल द CBI हैज गिवन अ क्लीन चिट टू अ मैन हु कुड नाउ बी देयर नेक्स्ट टॉप बॉस। अरविंद, व्हाट्स द लेटेस्ट?
Sonia, the Central Bureau of Investigation has given clean sheet to its former Special Director Rakesh Astana in an alleged bribery case involving Sterling Biotech. CBI in 2017 had registered an FIR against 3 IRS officers and unknown public servants for allegedly receiving kickbacks from the promoters of Sterling Biotech. Relying on the diary that was seized from the premises of the Sterling Biotech, the then CBI Director Alok Kumar had accused Rakesh Astana, who was the then Special Director in CBI, of receiving around 4 crore as bribe from a Sterling Biotech promoters. In fact, the Central Vigilance Commission, while ordering the removal of Rakesh Astana from CBI after the public spat, the ugly spat with Alok Verma, even the CVC had also relied on the very same case, saying that this particular matter needs an independent inquiry, and that's why they had ordered Rakesh Astana to be removed from the Central Bureau of Investigation. So after 3 years of investigation, now the Central Bureau of Investigation has come to a conclusion that there is no evidence against Rakesh Astana, and then they have cleared Rakesh Astana of all the charges in the Sterling Biotech case also. So this is the second clean sheet that the Rakesh Astana has got in the span of 12 months. Earlier we saw Rakesh Astana getting a clean sheet in a Moin Qureshi linked bribery case also. Mm-hmm. So with the 2 clean sheet, back-to-back clean sheet, there is no hurdle in front of Rakesh Astana to become the next CBI chief. What our sources are saying, that very soon the high power committee led by Prime Minister Narendra Modi will be meeting, which also includes the Chief Justice of India and also the opposition party, leader of opposition party, to select the next CBI director, right. Whereas Rakesh Astana is a strong contender in that list.
Arvind, thanks so much for that update. Well, a quick look at other news. Well, activist Deep Sidhu, but the main accused in the violence at the Red Fort complex in Delhi on Republic Day, has been arrested near Delhi. He's now been sent to 7 days police custody by a court. He was caught in Karnal in Haryana, just about 100 kilometers from Delhi. Reports said he kept changing his location to evade arrest. He's been accused of fueling chaos and clashes when a tractor rally by farmers protesting the farm laws actually led to violence. There was violence at the Red Fort when some farmers went there and climbed the Red Fort ramparts. And again, farmer unions have said that they had nothing to do with this, and this was actually fueled by Deep Sidhu and others. A quick look at the markets. Well, today, after almost an 8-day budget high, the markets ended flat, closing slightly in the red after their 6-day post-budget rally. The Sensex down by just 19 points, but closing over 51,000. The Nifty also down just 6 points, mainly because of the Nifty Auto Pharma down over 1%. And experts say there's still reason to remain cautiously optimistic. This mainly because of late profit booking in recent outperforming auto, metal, PSU banking and pharma shares led to the Sensex declining. But what's not declining are petrol and diesel prices, which are touching new all-time highs. What does this mean for a family's budget? Take a look.
Navnath works as a salesman. He uses his personal bike to travel for work. But with rising petrol prices and expenses, he is cutting down on his daily eating habits. Earlier, he used to spend 700 to 800 weekly, but now it has gone up to ₹1,500.
पहले हम लोग थोड़ा सा कभी बिस्किट्स, कभी ड्राई फ्रूट्स, कभी फ्रूट्स ये सब खाते थे, बच्चे लोगों को खिलाते थे। लेकिन अभी इनकम सोर्स कम होने के कारण से जो सैलरी आती है उसमें से कुछ पैसा हमें पेट्रोल में, कुछ सब्जी और कुछ अपने फूड्स में हम लोगों को देना पड़ता है।
But gas prices have gone up as well. CNG and PNG LPG gas cylinder prices have gone up too. In Mumbai, LPG cylinder is at ₹719 from February 4, which was 694 from December 15. CNG price is at 49.40 per kg, up from 47.90 per kg. PNG price is at 29.85 per kg, up from ₹28.90 per kg. The hike impacts about 7.5 lakh autos, taxis and buses in Mumbai.
Roz 10-15 rupees ka gas ja raha jata, ye dhanda nahi hai.
Nahi, ab ek hamara 5 ka घर में औरत है, बच्चे हैं, हम अकेले का कमाने का है।
हाँ।
203 से इधर जाए तो 200 बचेगा तो घर के लिए हो जाएगा।
Over 7 lakh households that use pipe natural gas for cooking, along with LPG cylinder users, are impacted too. Pranita Nangaukar lost her job as jewelry designer during the lockdown. Her husband is the only one earning in the house, and with rising fuel prices, it is getting difficult to manage. Suvarna Narvekar uses 2 cooking cylinders a month. The 25 rupee hike per cylinder to 719 hurts her vastly stretched budget.
Gas cylinder आणि petrol यांच्या वाढत्या भावामुळे आम्हाला थोडे compromise करायला लागतात. माझा पहिला घर खर्च 5,000 होता, तो आता direct 7,500 गेलाय.
आम्ही 4 माणसं खाणार, 5 माणसं खाणारी आणि दोघं कमावे करतात, सून आणि मुलगा. मग कसं जमणार? परत डॉक्टरचा पैसा, सिलिंडर इतना महाग झाला, मग काय करणार सांग ना.
The rising prices of fuel and gas have now started impacting people's household budgets. People have already seen job cuts and income losses this season. This is a big hole in their pocket. In Mumbai, with camera person Praveen G. Rohit and Rajendra Dayalkar, this is Purva Chitnis for NDTV.